A few years ago, Vladimir Moss pointed me to the Russian True Orthodox Church. I then did an online search and found that there were two groups claiming to be the Russian True Orthodox Church, one under Archbishop Alexei and the other under Bishop Stefan. This didn't make sense to me. In the old calendarist movement, there was already enough confusion. There was no way for the average person to know which of the old calendarist groups is the true one, because the answer to the question, which of these groups is a true one, depends on the subjective opinion, knowledge, and honesty of the person you happen to be asking the question to. You are not guaranteed infallibility with these people. The system is subjective, and you may be dealing with the personal biases and prejudices of fallible human beings. At any rate, Vladimir Moss referred me to the RTOC under Bishop Stefan. I contacted Bishop Stefan, and he started out good. I expressed to him an interest in monasticism. He suggested that I get land and try to live a kind of monastic life there, since the RTOC does not have any monasteries in this country. Vladimir Moss had also pointed me to the RTOC priest Father Joseph in Portland. He also started out good and once mailed me a schedule for church services. Then one time he told me to ask for blessings in my emails. I started doing that, but I noticed that he would not bless me in his responses. I didn't understand that. I then told him that I had bad vibes toward him. It seems like from that point on, he became less supportive, but this is speculation on my part. I then contacted RTOC priest Father Vladimir Mordvinkin in Sacramento and told him that I was interested in attending his church and joining the RTOC. He replied and wanted a copy of my ROCOR baptismal certificate and informed me that they spoke in Russian at his church. He also said he would consult with Bishop Stefan about this. He also encouraged me to contact Bishop Stefan and gave me his email address. When I again informed Father Vladimir that I wanted to go to his church, he pointed me to Father Joseph in Portland. I then told Father Vladimir that I did not want to go to Father Joseph's church for personal reasons. And then Father Vladimir pointed me to St. Herman's Monastery in Platina, and the reason he gave was because they were closer to where I lived. I was surprised by this advice because St. Herman's Monastery belongs to the Serbian Patriarchate, which I thought the RTOC believed to be apostate and heretical. I then wrote Father Vladimir back and told him that St. Herman's Monastery was with the Serbian Patriarchate. Father Vladimir never offered any explanation for why he had directed me to the Serbian Patriarchate, and he never wrote me again. This happened in April of 2010. I then reported this to Bishop Stefan, and he never answered and never wrote me again. I also shared this with Vladimir Moss, the person who had pointed me to the RTOC, and he replied and asked me if I was sure it was the Father Vladimir under Bishop Stefan, and I answered yes and eventually sent Vladimir Moss a copy of my email correspondence with Father Vladimir Mordvinkin. Vladimir Moss never offered any explanation either. These people left me hanging. If Father Vladimir believed in the official ecclesiology of his own RTOC jurisdiction, then there was absolutely no justification for him to point me to the Serbian Patriarchate. During the Nativity Fast of 2011, I believe, I emailed Father Joseph in Portland and asked if I could take vitamin D3 during the fast. He never answered my question. If I were a priest and my worst enemy had contacted me asking if he could take vitamin D3 during the Nativity Fast, I would have been delighted that he was so enthusiastic about observing the fast in so much detail, and I would have answered him speedily. I think it was the Pascha service of 2012 when I attended the RTOC parish in San Francisco. Father Oleg was serving, and he was very nice to me in person. That's one thing I've noticed with some old calendar's clergy. They're really nice to me in person, but when I leave their presence and go home, it's like they never want to have anything to do with me again. Father Oleg drove me to the bus terminal. When I got home, I mailed that church $10 in gratitude for the ride to the bus terminal. When I had later written and told Father Oleg about how Father Vladimir Mordvinkin had pointed me to a parish in the Serbian Patriarchate, he also never bothered to offer any kind of explanation. Father Oleg was nice to me in person, but afterwards it seems like he wanted nothing to do with me. It was not my fault that Father Vladimir Mordvinkin had directed me to a church which his own church claims to be apostate. Father Vladimir is responsible for initiating this scandal. Sometime during those days, I spoke to Father Joseph of Portland on the phone, and if I remember correctly, he said he did not know why Father Vladimir had pointed me to the Serbian Patriarchate. I eventually decided to inform all the RTOC clergy that Father Vladimir Mordvinkin had pointed me to the Serbian Patriarchate, and I emailed and sent physical mail to all the RTOC clergy whose addresses I could find online, and told them that if I did not get an explanation for what Father Vladimir had done, I would make a YouTube video sharing this story with people on the internet. One letter was sent back to me, and the reason written on the envelope was because I did not put my name on it. Only one of their priests, named Father John, replied to me, and he encouraged me not to make the video. He did not have an explanation for what Father Vladimir had done. Upon dialoguing with them, I discovered another issue. Father John told me that he receives Roman Catholics by chrismation. Some Orthodox Christians would have a problem with that because it is a general practice of the Roman Catholic Church to receive people by pouring water on their head three times. It's called effusion. So these Orthodox Christians would argue that since there is no economia for effusion, Roman Catholics should be baptized by triple immersion when they join the Orthodox Church. Father John told me that people who want Roman Catholics to be baptized when they join Orthodoxy are fanatics. Actually, that's not true. Baptizing Roman Catholics when they join the Orthodox Church is a valid tradition. Historically, Mount Athos has baptized Roman Catholics when they join the Orthodox Church, and this was the view of St. Nicodemus the Hagiarite. When I realized that there would be no explanation from Bishop Stefan or Father Vladimir for why the latter pointed me to the Serbian Patriarchate, I decided to make a video. These people would rather have you and I scandalized and have the image of their church dragged through the mud than to exercise prudence by thinking of the greater good a simple explanation from Bishop Stefan or Father Vladimir would have served. It seems like they had no regard for the fact that people would be scandalized and the fact that the image of their church would be dragged through the mud. My original video has been removed because I didn't care how I worded things. I shared that video with Archbishop Alexei, leader of the other RTOC group, and he replied to me and said that it was wrong that Father Vladimir had pointed me to a church in the Serbian Patriarchate and that I should not have to be going through this. And he said he would pray for me. That's the kind of response I should have received from Bishop Stefan, and Stefan should have thanked me for informing him about what one of his priests had done, and he should have assured me that he would check into it instead of leaving me confused. I also shared this story with the GOC Makarios priest monk Elder Gabriel, and his only reply was, "As for Stefan, he does not hold Orthodoxy." End quote. I also wrote Bishop Stefan and Father Vladimir and accused them of lacking in Christian love, and later on I told them that I wanted a spiritual father. I was willing to start over and pardon Father Vladimir's transgression. As far as his own church is concerned, it was a transgression for him to point me to the Serbian Patriarchate. I emailed Father Joseph in Portland and told him that I was willing to start over with him, but that I needed answers to certain polemical questions before I joined the RTOC. I could not uncritically join the RTOC until they proved their orthodoxy to me. Vladimir Moss had once written in one of his books or articles, "We are not permitted to recognize a bishop until he has shown himself completely orthodox in word and deed," end quote. Bishop Stefan did not prove his orthodoxy to me, so I could not just jump into his jurisdiction, especially in light of the scandal and confusion Father Vladimir Mordvinkin had initiated. Father Joseph refused to answer my questions. I quoted to him a couple canons I believed he was violating by not assisting me here, and he said I was not the interpreter of the canons. But he didn't give any reason for why he believed my interpretation of them was wrong. He could have reached out and clarified a possible misunderstanding I may have had about those canons, but he did not. I may have judged him, but that would not be a valid reason for him not to answer my questions about his church. As previously noted, I was willing to start over with Father Joseph, but in order for me to do so, he needed to prove the orthodoxy of the RTOC by answering my questions. He refused. So this is my story. Father Vladimir Mordvinkin had initiated a scandal, and Bishop Stefan and Father Vladimir refused to offer any kind of explanation for it. Bishop Stefan and Father Vladimir could have totally neutralized the scandal and brought it to rest, but they refused. When you have a situation where it is within your ability to totally neutralize a scandal, you should reach out and physically act. Don't just pray about something, act. It's okay to do that. All it would have taken to prevent this video from being made is a simple explanation from Bishop Stefan or Father Vladimir for why the latter pointed me to the Serbian Patriarchate. I have additional information. I have been corresponding with a member of HOCNA, and he told me that the RTOC parish in San Francisco communes HOCNA members on major feast days and if his HOCNA parish has no visiting clergymen. The RTOC parish in San Francisco is served by Father Joseph of Portland and Father Oleg of Seattle. Thank you for listening. See the description box below for more information and click the button below that says About.